oxygen. Planes carry oxygen supplies, so do divers and astronauts. Liquid nitrogen is very cold. It boils at around minus 196 degrees Celsius. So it is used to quick freeze food in food factories and to freeze liquid in cracked pipes before repairing. The atmosphere is the blanket of gas around the Earth. It is about 700 kilometers thick. We live in the lowest layer, the troposphere. The gas is at its most dense here, thanks to gravity. Here, the troposphere, we usually cool the atmosphere air. So what is in air? The air is approximately 21% oxygen and 78% nitrogen. The remaining 1% is mainly argon, plus a little carbon dioxide, plus a little water vapor, plus a small amount of other noble gases like helium, neon, krypton, and xenon. The composition of air changes very slightly from day to day and place to place. For example, there is more water vapor in the day around you on a damp day. Pollutants such as carbon monoxide and sulfur dioxide are likely to be given out from busy cities and industrial areas. But since air is continuously on the move, the pollutants get spread around too. Most of the gases in the air are essential to us. For example, we depend on plants for food and they depend on carbon dioxide. And without nitrogen to dilute the oxygen, fuel would burn too fast for us. But the gas we depend on most is oxygen. Without oxygen, we would quickly die. We need it in the process called respiration that goes on in all our cells. Glucose plus oxygen is equal carbon dioxide plus water plus energy. The energy from the respiration keeps us warm and allows us to move and enables hundreds of different reactions to go on in our bodies. And look, respiration doesn't only take part in humans but in cells of all living things. So what are the uses of these two gases that we use the most, nitrogen and oxygen? For oxygen, planes carry oxygen supplies, so do divers and astronauts. In hospitals, patients with breathing problems are given oxygen through an oxygen mask and in an oxygen tank. This is a plastic tank that fits over the head. Oxygen-rich air is pumped into it. In steelworks, oxygen is used in converting the impure iron from the blast furnaces into steel. A mixture of oxygen and the gas acetylene C2H2 is used as the fuel in oxyacetylene torches for cutting and welding metal. When this gas mixture burns, the flame can reach up to 6000 degrees Celsius. Steel melts at around 3150 degrees Celsius, so the flame cuts through by melting it. Okay, now nitrogen. Liquid nitrogen is very cold. It boils at around minus 196 degrees Celsius. So it is used to quick freeze food in food factories and to freeze liquid in cracked pipes before repairing them. It is also used in hospitals to store tissue samples. Nitrogen is unreactive, so it's flushed through the food packaging to remove oxygen and keep the food fresh. Oxygen helps decay. So in the frozen factories, food is dipped into liquid nitrogen to quick freeze it. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to share and subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos.